What's up, everybody? I'm DeLa True, and this is The Passion Space. I'm about to get my tattoo by Ace. It's gonna hurt, but I'm looking forward to it, so yeah. Hope you enjoy it. I had this art teacher and shit, like I was doing bad in school, so I got sent to like a second chance high school. The art teacher was flooded with tattoos. My name was Jackie. And everybody was just into tats. It was like 2008. Lil Wayne was popping.
Yeah.
He was fucking tatted up. So, you know, I was just always like in the hustling and shit, being optimistic. So I asked her, where can I get some equipment from? She got a friend that actually worked in the spot in the city. It's called Unimax on Canal Street.
Yeah.
I went, got my equipment from there, and then I just took it from there.
Yeah.
I'm tattooing fruits and shit in my bedroom.
Yourself?
Nah, just like fruits, oranges, and fucking banana peels and shit.
But at what point did you feel like you could actually turn it into a business, though, at such a young age?
From day one.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, I know how money works. I know what makes people want to be inclined to spend money.
So, but as a new tattoo artist though at the time, who was actually letting you tattoo them?
Everybody.
Oh, you had support from the beginning?
I had support from the jump. I always had support. Like, everybody knew that I could draw my ass off, so I was like that kid in school drawing on the table, drawing this. I'm saying everybody's like, yo, this nigga Ace could draw this nigga.
Yeah.
When I first started, people were fucking overselling me. Like, yo, my man's got tats, yo, he could do anything. Da-da-da-da. I'm like, fuck you, bring him in. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I mean, I fucked up like mad tattoos.
Oh, for real?
Hell yeah. Oh, shit. Like, they were satisfactory. Like, I never was completely trashed.
Oh, yeah?
But it was a lot of things that I just didn't know. Like, I still made my mistakes.
Yeah. I read somewhere where it says black tattoo artists do have a problem where people question their integrity a lot. Do you feel that way? Do you feel people do that to you?
Every day. All the time. People always question.
Wow.
Like, I've had people, like, I showed them my work. Oh, you didn't do this. You know what I'm saying? All types of shit. I don't think it's just because I'm black. Like, I've been told, like, I have a ghetto demeanor or whatever. But I've been in the streets for a long time. And, like, I'm from a time where that shit was cool. So,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all you know. And it's like, you were more so worried about coming outside and being comfortable. So,
yeah.
We didn't really care too much about being intelligent. It was more about if you're tough or not. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then that shit just kind of stayed with me all into adulthood. So when you see people like that, you're used to them being, you know, drug dealers, rappers, maybe some sports or whatever here and there, but not really artists like doing sophisticated artwork and shit. So I guess that would play into it too. But I just felt like it was mostly because I'm black at the end of the day. Like, I appreciate it though, the struggle, because it made me grind harder. Like, it made me really grind harder. And a lot of tattoo artists, like, I would say they kind of have shit easy. Like, they look a certain way, or they, I don't know, they just, whatever it is, whatever handicap they have, or how they get their clientele, it just, it doesn't really make them stronger or better as an artist the way.
How do you push through that though? Cause you can't just, how you push through it? Cause you can't just sit back and say, everyone's giving me problems because I'm black. What do you do to get through all that pressure?
It makes the proving factor like that much more worth it. Like, you know, like after I see people fronting and shit, and then when they witness me doing some shit, it's like, it feels 10 times better, you know what I'm saying? I feel like I'm knocking down stereotypes and shit like that. Like, look what the fuck the hood can do. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we more than just what y'all think we are. We wear many hats in the urban community, you know? You can't judge a book by its cover. It feels like a victory every time. Yeah. I love it. I really do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? In the beginning, and sometimes it still gets to me. Like, I don't feel comfortable in certain places, or I feel like I'm gonna get overlooked.
Yeah.
I'm saying, but
like when you go to conventions or something?
I've never been to a convention. It's probably for those same reasons.
Oh, you feel like you're being judged?
Yeah, exactly.
That's crazy.
It's like that, man. Yeah. But what's the crazy part is when my fellow black people, you know what I'm saying, are that fucking brainwashed. Like, I've heard many people say, for tattoos, and I'm like, why? Like, which is crazy, like, most people don't even know the majority of people on Jamaica Avenue that do tattoos aren't black. Like, they're white and Asian.
Yeah.
And they do the most fucking drugs. Like, they over there sniffing, smoking meth, all types of crazy shit, doing coke. And they'll be right there tattooing, and people will trust them just because traditionally, like, they feel like that's what a tattoo artist looks like.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Based off tradition, like. And you see, now, like, black artists are really getting more exposure. You have shows like Black Ink or whatever, and then you have the social media to expose more and more black artists, but.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Traditionally, coming up, that's just not what you would expect from somebody in an urban environment like that.
Word. And that's what keeps you motivated too?
OD keeps me motivated. What mostly keeps me motivated is that, like, this shit is fun and, like, I'm growing with this shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, the people are growing with me, like,
yeah.
It's people that, I have people stop me in the streets, yo, hey, what's up, yo, you remember me that? I don't even remember everybody sometimes, you know, I do so many fucking tattoo jobs for people.
Yeah.
It gets crazy sometimes, like, but it's a good feeling, you know, I feel like I was, maybe in my past life, I was like that old African shaman that, you know, that fucking did the tribal shit for the warriors and shit, you know what I'm saying, like, I don't know. It gives me purpose, so it really gives me a lot of money too. It pays the bills, you know.
Yeah.
I love it.
So you definitely think the owning your own business is definitely the route to go?
Yeah. I would definitely say that. Like, in America especially, no matter what you do, you have to own your own business, man, because there's nothing really stopping you but what you believe about yourself. It's like,
yeah.
And it's not really so much about even being intelligent. It's more about being creative. I'm saying the creativity on how to approach what you're trying to get done. There's a million people that does the same thing, you know what I'm saying? But different people thrive and prosper because of the approach they take to doing it, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta have a unique approach. That's so where the creativity
What is. Do you think is the most important quality to have, though, to continue that business? I think it's consistency, you know? What can you tell me about?
It's consistency and it's definitely perseverance.
Yeah.
You gotta have perseverance to remain consistent because there's times where shit does get slow, shit shuts down, nobody fucking notices you. You just gotta persevere through those times.
So what are you doing?
You gotta survive that shit.
What are you doing to happen then?
When that happens, I usually would just take that time to focus on my drawings. I'll try to constantly improve in something in my life, you know what I'm saying? If I'm having downtime, I'm working out, I'm exercising, I'm meditating, I'm reading up on a book or something. I'm never just ever going to be stagnated, you know what I'm saying? I can't.
Yeah.
I feel like, because, you know, it's not the money that makes me happy, but when it comes to this business, that's cool and shit, like, money is cool, but what really pushes me to grow in life, to live life, is growing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's like when you first played that Pokemon game and you watched this shit evolve and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's a good feeling, like, you level up. That's what it's all about to me, to level up. Like, I started working under somebody and now I'm sitting here owning my own business, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Keeping my money in my own pocket.
Yeah.
So all percentage goes straight to me. That's a good feeling. To have my own apprentices, to have people that look up to me.
Yeah.
That shit feels good, you know, and it keeps growing from there. Like I said, I've always had good support. I've always had encouragement. But when you're an artist, you tend to focus more on the people that don't fuck with you. You know what I mean?
That's a lot of people.
Focus more on the haters.
That's a lot of people's problems.
You know what I'm saying?
They don't focus on who loves them, they focus on more who hates on them.
That shit, it's kind of like motivation because...
Focus on your haters?
Yeah, like when you want to reach a state where you want everybody to like you and appreciate you because you feel like all you've been portraying are your good qualities, you know what I'm saying? Your loyalty, your work ethic, your drive and all that, and people still don't like you. It makes you just want to constantly keep improving yourself, you know? Sometimes it probably won't be healthy, but at times it's a good thing.
Yeah.
I'm saying, because sometimes maybe you do need things that you can still improve on, you know what I'm saying? Even if they're just fucking not fucking with you for whatever nonchalant, petty reason, it's still beneficial to you at the end of the day. As a person, I believe you can never stop growing.
I'd like to thank Ace for coming on the Passion Space and giving me this dope tat.
My man, you already know.
Let them know your address.
You know what I mean? That's 11134 Farmers Boulevard. Come get your fucking ink. You already know.
That'll also be at the end of the video, so you can also just come through. Queens finest tattoo artist.
Get this work right here, man. Get that.
Yeah, this shit's dope. My life.
Get that beautiful little self-portrait right there, my man. Africa.
Stay black. Stay black. Hey. Cool. Peace.